Hello friends, so today we are doing a very important question for CAT. It is also a very important question for SSC Tier 2 and many other exams in which tough questions are asked. So first question is 100 raised to power 1 into 99 raised to power 2 into 98 raised to power 3 dash 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 up to 1 to the power 100, find number of zeros. Zero means yahan pe hamara trailing zeros. This question is all about trailing zeros. Okay. Trailing zeros, I will tell you the basic first of all. And the second question is 99 to the raised power 4, 98 raised to the power 5, 1 to the power 102. And we have to find the number of trailing zeros. It is given at the end of this product. End of this product means trailing zeros. It is obvious. If it is given that end of this product means they are interested in trailing zeros. Okay. Any doubt? Okay. But you can take the screenshot of this question. And if you don't know the question, then please check the video solution. If you know the basics, then you can forward this question till 5 minutes. Or you can see all the basics regarding this question. So I will tell you the three basics of this question that will be used in this question. First of all, you should know about number of terms of an AP. How many of you know this concept? Of a AP. AP means arithmetic progression. Like I give you a series 7, 11, 15, 19 up to 139, and you have to find the number of terms of this series. In childhood, you used to do this question by a long method. I want to tell you a trick to find number of terms. So the trick is, you can note down, trick to find number of terms of an AP is capital D upon small d plus 1. What is capital D? Capital D is the largest difference of this series. Means largest term minus smallest term. Means it is 139 minus 7. And what is small d? Small d is the common difference. Common difference is 4, 4, 4. Okay. Then we will divide by 4. And plus 1 is in the formula. So if we do this question, if we want to find the number of terms, it will be 132 by 4 plus 1. It means it will be 34 because it will cancel out at 33 plus 1. It will be 34 terms. So number of terms of an AP series can be found out by a trick. Capital D upon small d plus 1. What is capital D? Largest difference means largest term minus smallest term. And upon small d is common difference. I hope you got this basic. Now moving on to the second basic of this question. You already know sum of n terms of an AP. What is sum of n terms of an AP? You have two formula in childhood. N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. A is the first term of that AP. N is the number of terms. And second formula you learnt in childhood for finding sum. Yes, please recall. Yes, N by 2 into A plus L. What is L? Last term. What is A? First term. What is N? Number of terms of L of that AP for which we have to find out the sum of the series. Okay, can you calculate the sum of the series for 2 plus 5 plus 8 up to 182? Okay, right. First of all, number of terms formula, N capital D upon small d plus 1. Okay, what is capital D? It is largest difference, 182 minus 2, 180. What is small d? 3. And plus 1, it means this AP have 61 terms. Now we want to find the sum of these terms. So Sn is What is SN? SN n means 61 terms. 61 by 2 into A plus L. You can apply this formula A plus L because you know the last term as well. 182 na? What is A? It is 2. And what is L? It is 182. And if you solve this, 61 by 2 into 184, then you will easily able to find 92 into 61, that will come out as 5612. Okay, got this basic. Now, moving on to our original question. What was our original question? Our original question was, find the number of trailing zero in 100 to the power 1, 99 to the power 2, and 1 to the power 100. Okay. First of all, you should know the basics of trailing zeros as well. You know two basics, sum of n terms and number of terms of an AP that will be used in this question. But you must know about number of trailing zero. What is the meaning of number of trailing zeros? Okay. Suppose a number 300 is there. How many trailing zeros are there? Yes, there are two trailing zeros. Because trailing zeros are those sequence of zeros after which no other digit follows. Wo sequence hota hai zeros ka jiske baad koi aur digit nahi hota. To 300 mein do trailing zero hai. 300 have two trailing zeros. Now make prime factors of 300. 5 into 5 into 2 into 2 into 3. So 300 have 5 and 2 pairs as 2. There are 2 pairs of 5 into 2. So there will be 2 trailing zeros in 300s. So trailing zero depends upon numbers of pairs of 5 and 2 in that product. Okay. So if I talk about number 4000, you can easily tell me 4000 have 5 into 5 into 5 into 2 into 2 into 2. This is 1000. Again 2 and again 2. 5 into 5 25 into 5 125 into 2 250 into 2 500 into 2 1000 into 2 2000 into 2 4000. So 4000 have these prime factors. Okay, now pairs. First pair of 5 and 2, second pair of 5 and 2, and third pair of 5 and 2. There are 3 pairs. Rest 2 are not having pair with 5. So we will say that 4000 have 3 trailing zeros because it have 3 pairs of 5 and 2. Okay, got my point. Now, moving to our original question. What is our original question? 100 raised to the power 1 into 99 raised to the power 2 dash 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 up to 1 to the power 100. Now, we are doing the original question. Ready? Okay. First of all, think that 100 raised to power 1 into 99 raised to power 2 up to 1 to the power 100. This continuous product have number of 5s more or number of 2s more? Think. As it is a continuous integers with increasing powers, so it is evident that 5s are going to be less than number of 2s. So purpose is to find out 5, because if we think that the number of trailing zeros are product of 5 and 2, okay, if 5s are less, then it means only those pair will be formed to make trailing zeros. Okay, so our purpose in this question is to find out number of 5s. So where we will get 5 in this question? Yes, 100 to the power 1. And where? 95 to the power what? We will get 15 in 95. But what is the power? See carefully in this question. Base and power sum is 101. 100 plus 1, 101. 99 plus 2, 101. 1 plus 100, 101. So obviously, it is clearly visible that 95 will have 6th power. And 90 will have, 11th power. Because 90 plus 11 is 101. Okay. Moving, this we will do up till 5 to the power 96. These terms have 5 in them. Okay, clear. And there are some terms that will have extra 5. Can you tell me those terms? okay, I am writing separately. Those terms will be 100 to the power 1. It will have 2 5. 100 is 5 into 5 into 4. So 100 have 2 5s in it. Okay. And what is the power? 1 power. So 100 raised power 1 will have 2 5s. What about 75? 5 into 5 into 3. Number 75 is 5 into 5 into 3. So number 75 have 2 5 in it. And what is the power? 75 raised to power 26. Very good. Because base plus power sum is 101. Very good. And 50 will have also 2 5, but 50 to the power 51. Okay. 25 will have also 2 5, but 25 to the power 76. You are understanding this concept. Okay. Now moving on to the original question. 100 raised to power 1 have 2 5. So I am writing 1 here and 1 here because I will make a AP. Okay, 95 to the power 6 have 1 5, but power is 6. So there we will get 6 5s. Okay, getting my point. 90 to the power 11 have 90 is having 1 5, but power is 11. So we will get 11 5. Got my point. This series goes on. What about 75? It will have 26 power, na? But 75 is having 2 5s, so we will get 52 power. We are writing 26 here and 26 beneath it because we will add separately those 5s because here we will form a AP. What about 50 to the power 51? It will have 51 into 2, 102 5s. We are writing 51 here and 51 here because we will add it separately. What about 25? Yes, very good. 25 raised to power 76. We will write 76 here and 76 here because 25 raised to power 76 will have 152 5s. We are writing 76 here and 76 beneath it. Okay, the last term we will be having 5 to power 96. It will have 96 5. So we are forming a AP. You are getting it, my point. We are forming an AP with first term 1 and common difference 5, 5, okay, 5, 5, 5. Next we'll have, next term will have 16 5s, okay. And we will add extra 5s here. So, what is the sum of this AP? Please let me know. The sum of the AP is n by 2 into a plus l. What is the sum of this series? N by 2 into a plus n, and what is the number of terms? Please let me know. What is the number of terms? N is d by d plus 1. What is the number of terms in this series? 96 minus 1. 96 is the largest term of this series, and 1 is the smallest term. 95. And what is the small d? It is 5 plus 1. So this series has 20 terms. This series have 20 terms. Okay, got my point. And what is the sum of the series? N by 2 into A plus L. I am writing here. Okay. What is the sum of the series? N by 2 into A plus L. Okay, got my point. So, if you sum the series, what is N? N is 20, 20 by 2, A, what is A? 1, L, what is L? Last term is 96, so 97 into 20 by 2, 970. 975 is not our final answer. Why? Because we have some extra 5s we need to add. 1, 26, 51 and 76. Okay, so if we add 1 plus 26 plus 51 plus 76, we will get 154. So we need to add this 154 also. So we will get 1124. So 1124 fives in this series. And number of 2s are more than 1124 because in every second term we will get number of 2s, but in every fifth term we will get number of 5s according to powers. So answer of this question is 1 1 2 4, because we will form 1 1 2 4 pairs of 5 and 2. Rest of the 2s are remaining 2s and we don't need them, because number of trailing 0 depends upon number of pairs of 5 and 2. Okay, try second question and write in the comment box, and if you have any problem you can ask me on my WhatsApp number. My WhatsApp number is 9813646268. This is my WhatsApp number. You can WhatsApp me on this number for your doubt. Thank you very much. Good night.